Come here, Samuel. Hey, Stone. Right there. So let me call on the three witnesses. You know, obviously, they've got different names to what their normal names are, so the first person I'm going to speak to, his name is Di. So, Di, can you tell me what you were doing in the field that night?
I mean, the boys just out for a little munch, like, you know, what do you mean it was for? And I seen this bit of idea, screaming in the field, and just going round and round, and you know what's going on, like.
Would you agree with that statement, Frank?
Yeah, that's right.
They were
just
bullshit
all the time, yeah.
What? Bullshit, Frank.
Bullshit.
Can you agree with him, Mark?
No. It wasn't cow shit. It was bullshit. We had a bit of wager, see what's going on. See, I had a bit of wet, see how many times we went around, like, innit? And I did it right. I took 20 quid out of the boys that night. We went around 10 times.
Well, thanks for being so honest and coming forward to tell us your story, guys. So Paul and Chris nearly covered 60 miles, just short of 100k distance, in just over 15 hours. But we're still around 10 miles from the finish. To get that extra distance, they literally must have circled that field at least 10 times. At this point, the course marshal would like to point out that at no point of the course, everybody followed the markers, and nobody else got lost that day. The girl that was behind them took less than 10 minutes to go through the field, and I think she was walking too. And the most amazing thing is that they'd already been through the field 3 times that day. So ladies and gentlemen, keep your hands together for tonight's winners of the Crapper of the Year Award, Sir Paul Harris and Chris Rand. Chris Tyler.
Come on, boys.
Just to show what you've actually got to do to get a crap out of the advice, you've just got to walk in crap. Well, boys, 6 months of test, 6 months of ball.
Well done.
It can't be. They should be around 5 or 6 miles away from here now, as they passed you well over an hour ago. They pulled over and it was them. They'd basically gone into the fields in the dark, gone round in one big circle, but then back out where they started. What went on in the field, nobody knows. But they both had enough and asked to get in the car as they were going. Right then. So using my newfound journalistic skills, I set the task to get to the bottom of this story. So using Google Maps, Jeff, that's the thing on the internet you're not sure about, right? And out of a local farmer called Morgan the Goat, we actually found 3 witnesses who were willing to come forward and testify. So, to respect the anonymity of these witnesses, we have to blindfold the trespassers to give the witnesses different names. So boys, fortunately got a blindfold you.
Okay.
Yeah, so what are you doing? Just doing them. 16 hours. Paul and Chris got back to the halfway point at 7 hours and 24 minutes. It was absolutely belting down. They had an option to drop to the 50k and finish the race there and then at the pub. But they both decided to go out for the second lap and try and finish the 100k. At around 11 p.m, I hear that they passed the second to last checkpoint and was expecting them to finish around 12:30. They'd missed the cutoff, but this wasn't going to be enforced anyway. There was also a girl up on the course who was around 30 minutes behind them. Nathan and Tori drove out to see if they could see the girl as she was on her own, and they just wanted to make sure she was okay, perhaps to try to get her to catch up with Paul and Chris so they could run together. After checking on the girl, they made their way to the last checkpoint where Andrew, Aaron and Lisa were just about to finish their last stint of volunteering. When they were driving up the road, they noticed at the side of the road 2 runners looking very confused and pissed off. I just think Nathan in the room a minute. You just sit down there a minute. Nathan, come in.
What's your name?
Stand with the boys.
Bet you get it blindfolded, Jeff.
Right then. Jeff. Nathan did this big race in Greece, right?
Alright.
From Athens to Sparta, 153 miles non-stop. So now I'm going to show you the finish of that race. Unfortunately, King Leonidas of Sparta couldn't make it the performance tonight. He's been dead for 2,000 years. So we had a little search on Google, right, to find the nearest living relative. And we managed to get over them tonight. We found a rink here in Wales. He works in Sparta, look at that. So please make him welcome. King Bukakis of Sparta. When Nathan comes in, he hasn't got a clue what's happening, right? Okay? So big cheer, you run in the finish, job done. Hang on 5 minutes, I've got one other thing left to get.
Boot us.
Half those early boys.
Okay. So, I need a good digital clock. So, I know someone who's absolutely exceptional at timekeeping, unfortunately, he isn't. Chris Simons, can you hear please?
PB,
and what? I think Chris. Oh, now that's me. You're the clock, right? he's the clock, right? Okay, and that's the thing up here he did. Well, it's 40 seconds wrong because Chris is crap at keeping time, see? All right? 1 second. Right then, Nathan, I want you to run in the room, right? They don't know that you come in. Okay, big surprise. They went flat and think you finished the race. So when you run in now, big cheer. So do a similar sort of thing you've done when you finished in Greece, and you'll enjoy it. 1 second. Forgot his trophy, man. Right, Nathan, come in, please. Big round of applause. Let's get a cozy!
Ladies.